Traffic, it's irritating wherever you are, but for people in California, a basic trip from San Francisco to LA can take at least 6 hours. So what's there to do when cars can't get the job done? Well, there's bullet trains, but Tesla's Elon Musk claims he has a better solution for the solution, and he's calling it the Hyperloop. Forget cars, how's hopping in a pod and riding at over 700 miles per hour sound? Terrifying? Yes. Still cool, come on, yes. Though we're not quite at Marty McFly status with flying cars, the Hyperloop looks to be our closest step. In reaction to California's high-speed rail system that's currently under development, in a recent blog, Musk shared his disappointment with the new bullet train, claiming that A, it's too expensive, and B, it's actually too slow. Also pointing that such an investment should have many benefits, like being safer, faster, sustainably self-powering, and more. And yeah, such requests should have answers, and well, Musk's blog has a 58-page journal attached with all the technicalities if you're looking to get into that. But for many, you just want to know how it's supposed to work. Well, the Hyperloop is basically two ginormous tubes that stretch between the two cities. Pods go through these tubes at about 700 miles per hour, and voila, you're from point A to point B, and it's called propulsion that gets you there. It's magnetic accelerators that are placed throughout the tubes that help the pods move forward. To reduce resistance, the tube would be a low pressure environment. That would allow the pods to reach higher speeds using the least amount of energy. But even in a near vacuum, pressure would build up, especially in these tight tubes. To prevent buildup, Musk design places an air compressor on the front of the pod, helping air move from the front to the tail thanks to air displacement. Okay, but why is this so important though? Well, think about the modes of transportation we already have. Planes, boats, cars, and trains, right? Now think about how long we've had them and how well they've done at eating up money, harming the environment, and at not really being that fast. We're really starting to eat up those options with the way that we're consuming energy, so finding a more efficient way to move a lot of people at once is important now more than ever. It's a complex concept, and while Musk's Hyperloop does offer some valid solutions like outsourcing for pod designs from engineering prodigies, solar panels on the roof for self-power, and pylon mounts to withstand earthquakes, but even so, it's still facing plenty of difficulties like, well, the most important one, money. For now, a test track is expected to break ground next year, costing about $100 million and demoing the idea at just 200 miles per hour this time around. California's high-speed rail is expected to cost about $67 billion, while the Hyperloop's 400-mile system is expected to only cost $8. Without development cost, that is, but even so, with a concept at this size with equal amounts of potential, you can't help but wonder, maybe this will actually work. But I'm still wondering the same question. How long will it take for us to actually get there?